What we're hoping is that the technology that we're developing here can help teach and train children with autism to better attend to the appropriate cues in a social situation, and also to use what we're developing to model pro-social behaviors.
We think this can be very beneficial because children with autism, they do not pay much attention to the world outside, but they are very interested in their own image.
So what's really neat about this technology is that we can show a user a virtual world where they see themselves, and maybe they see themselves engaging in the kinds of pro-social behaviors that we'd like for them to imitate or to follow. And that might be useful for them because they have difficulty watching and imitating others. Perhaps watching themselves engage in these behaviors will help them carry those behaviors beyond the virtual world and into the real world.
Existing VR technology has one typical limitation, is that you cannot see yourself.
This is not an easy task to figure out how to capture a person's movements and actions and to then render that in a virtual world.
We use a different type of sensors, including RGB sensors, lip motion sensors, and depth sensors. We capture the person's body movement from different perspective, and then we transfer this motion to a VR avatar.
We are starting with autism as one potential application here, but really, I think the sky's the limit here. There are all sorts of implications for how we teach and train people, and again, how we can employ this in therapeutic settings.
We believe this technology can be further extended in many different applications, like gymnastics. They wear the VR headset to see their gestures and compare their body motion with the target body motion, and to see the difference.